In this video, we will learn how to do addition, subtraction, and multiplication problems in ModMath. So the first thing to do is to go ahead and open up the app. You can see it opens up, it shows you all your different work that you've done. Go ahead and tap on the plus button. Let's go ahead and get started. So we'll start by doing a very simple problem. We're going to go ahead and do 3 plus 4. So a lot of times kids get their problems like that. They'll see them on a worksheet like that in the horizontal manner, but it may not be very helpful for them. So what we do is we teach them to change it to vertical. So we do 3, add the plus sign, 4. You'll notice it added in that line underneath. So now I'm ready to answer that question. 3 plus 4 equals 7. And that's great. Let's move on to a bit more complex problem. Let's try 15 plus 7. This is definitely one we want to write vertical, so we're going to do 15 plus, I'm going to move it over one more, 7. Now you'll notice it did not draw that line automatically for me. If I had put 15 plus 0, 7, it would have drawn the line. But I'm going to go ahead and add the line in myself. So I tap the square underneath where I want the line to go, and I tap the line tool. And now it's only covering one box, but if I long press on that dot, you'll see how it went dashed. There you go. Now I'm able to extend it. I'm going to go ahead and zoom in on this problem. I just use the regular zoom and pinch to zoom feature that's built into the iPad. Sometimes this is really helpful for our kids with math anxiety or visual impairments because it really helps them to just focus on the problem at hand. So 5 plus 7 is 12. So I write down my 2. And now I need to carry my 1. And I'm going to put my 1 up above. So 1 plus 1 is 2. My answer is 22. Easy? Cool. All right. We're going to go ahead and do another problem. This time we're going to do 17 plus 34. 17 plus 34. You'll notice my cursor moves in the right direction, and you'll notice it drew the line for me this time. So 7 plus 4 is 11, so I put my 1. I need to carry that 1. Now this time, maybe I don't want to put it on top because that's confusing. I can go to the symbol, the N, with the exponent box. And perhaps I would like to use this one so it goes before it. So now I have 1 plus 1 plus 3 is 5. It's 5. Thank you. So there's my answer, 51. All right, the next problem we're going to do is subtraction with regrouping. So we're going to go ahead and do 36 minus 28. If I have 6 and I cannot take away 8 from it. So I'm going to need to do some regrouping. So the first thing I'm going to do is go to that 3 and borrow 10. So I'm going to take that regrouping tool. It's the N with a slash through it. I'm going to cross out the 3. I'm going to borrow 10, which makes it 20. So I'm going to go back to that N tool, and I'm going to put it right here. I like to use this one to remind me that it's now a 2. And now that 6 becomes a 16 because I've borrowed 10. So I'm going to go to that N exponent, and I'm going to put it in front. So now I have 16. 16 minus 8 is 8. 2 minus 2 is 0. And that's how you use those exponent tools to higher functioning math. The next thing we're going to do is multiplication. 5 times 2. That's easy, right? It's 10. Here's where kids get tripped up. They're going to write 10. Is that how we teach them to write it, with the 0 hanging out? Nope. So we're going to go ahead and use the clear button. That's kind of your delete button. And I'm going to say, okay, 10, 0 in the 1 spot, 0 in the 1 spot, 1 in the 10 spot. And there's the answer for 10. Let's do even harder level math. Let's do 15, times 5. And again, I need to draw in my own line and drag it over. 5 times 5 is 25. Put the 5 in, carry that 2. So I can put it up above, or I can use that exponent tool. 5 times 1 is 5, add 2 more is 7, and there's my answer of 75. So now you know how to use ModMath to do addition, subtraction, and multiplication with and without regrouping. When you're done with your work and you're ready to share it with your teacher, one great way of doing that is using this little sharing arrow, because then you can use whatever apps you have, Dropbox or Google Drive or email, to share with your teacher. The other feature I want to point out before we go is this grid. Right now I've got it set to this one right here with the T in the middle column. You can set this to whatever works for your student based on their visual impairments or visual preferences. So you may want to let your student experiment to find what works for them. Thanks.